In California, if it's under $1,000 worth of goods taken, it's a misdemeanor. And so there are some who argue that by having that law in place, that just doesn't put a stop to this. Is that the case in all these cities? Is that part of this?
Think about this. In New York City, there are just over 300 people who have between them 4,000 arrests. 70% of them are not in jail, and they account for 30% of all shoplifting in New York. This is actually their job. They go out to steal every day, and that has gone up significantly because they know getting put in jail is not in the equation any longer because of the laws that say it's a no-bail offense, and DA's policies are they don't want people in custody for what they call nonviolent crimes. Interestingly, they did a survey of stores, the Retail Federation, in 22 that said 81% of their store associates feel that the people stealing are becoming more violent and aggressive when confronted, and 54% of them feel that this bail reform, where they have shoplifters telling them, there's nothing you can do and I'm not going to jail.
In Philadelphia, more than a dozen people this morning under arrest after a big group of looters ransacked an Apple store, a Lululemon, and a Foot Locker.
Well, what we saw in New York when we had the two nights of looting after the George Floyd protests were very similar, which is we had protesters marching in protesters. The looters came in caravans of cars. They were working in sophisticated communications networks. They had lookouts on scooters. They weren't there to protest. They were there to steal. They were talking about, you know, we're here to get paid. In Philadelphia, you see the protests they had yesterday. These weren't the protesters. These were young kids,